Friends, I want to welcome you to Good Shepherd. It's an honor to have you worship with us today. Today is the fifth Sunday after Epiphany. If you would just be so kind as to take a moment to let us know you're worshiping with us. If you're watching on a computer, Philip has the instructions on the screen. But if you've already downloaded our church app, just go to the worship tab and you'll see the check-in form right there. You can use that very easily. Let's prepare for worship.
Would you please stand with me? We gather in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
We gather as a people of God to offer repentance and praise, to pray for the unity of the church and the renewal of our common life. Trusting in God's mercy and compassion, let us ask for the forgiveness of our sins. Lord Jesus, you came to reconcile us to one and to the Father. Lord, have mercy on us.
Lord, have mercy on us.
Lord Jesus, you heal the wounds of pride and intolerance. Christ, have mercy on us.
Christ have mercy on us.
Lord Jesus, you pardoned the sinner and welcome the repentant. Lord, have mercy on us.
Lord, have mercy on us.
May Almighty God grant us pardon and peace, strengthen us in faith, and make us witnesses to Christ's love. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Good morning. Let's sing God's praise together. Here we go. Let's start the first verse right now. Take a listen once.
Let praise be a weapon that silences the enemy. Let praise be a weapon that conquers all anxiety. Let it rise. Let praise arise.
Come on, here we go.
We sing your name in the dark and it changes everything. Sing with all we are and we claim your victory. Let it rise. Let praise arise. We see you break down every wall. We watch the giants fall. Oh, fear cannot survive when we praise you. The God of breakthroughs on our side.
forever lift him high. With all creation cry, God, we praise you. Oh, 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 let faith be a song that overcomes the raging sea. Let faith be the song that calms the storm inside of me. Let it arise. Let faith arise. We'll see you break down every wall. We'll watch the giants fall. For fear cannot survive when we praise you. The God of breakthroughs on our side, forever lift him high. With all creation cry, God, we praise you. Oh, 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 we praise you. Oh, 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 oh.
We're going to break it down now with a little bridge. As always, I'll sing it first, and then you can follow.
This is what living looks like. This is what freedom feels like. This is what heaven sounds like. We praise you.
Let's sing it together. Come on.
This is what living looks like. This is what freedom feels like. This is what heaven sounds like. We praise you, we praise you. This is what living looks like. This is what freedom feels like. This is what heaven sounds like. We praise you, we praise you. This is what living looks like. This is what freedom feels like. This is what heaven sounds like. We praise you, we praise you. We'll see you break down every wall. We'll watch the giants fall. For fear cannot survive when we praise you. The God of breakthroughs on our side, forever lift you high. With all creation cry, God, we praise you. Oh,
let us pray. Everlasting God, you give strength to the weak and power to the faint. Make us agents of your healing and wholeness, that your good news may be known to the ends of creation, through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Amen. Friends, we know what a blessing it is when people who are unexpected reach out to us with words of encouragement. And so we encourage you to do just that today, to reach out to others in unexpected ways. The peace of Christ be with you always.
And also with you.
Let's share a sign of that peace.
Friends, good morning and God's peace to all of you on this Super Bowl Sunday. Just a couple announcements for you today. This year we've been asked to collect size 4 and size 5 diapers for Gaithersburg Help, which I know that you've been a part of. I was asked to make the announcement that that will continue throughout this coming week, so that collection will continue on, so please continue to support that. I want to remind you that Pastor Ted's class is now also going to be available via Zoom, so you can continue to watch on the church Facebook page, the website, but if you'd like to interact with Pastor Ted and be able to ask him questions, just send us an email and we'll get you that Zoom link. We're so delighted that you continue to be involved in the Sunday educational ministry of Good Shepherd. There is stuff for people of all ages, classes to in which to engage and keep growing in the faith. So let's just keep up with that. Wednesday evening is our final Wednesday evening service on this theme that we're doing, the hope for hard times, lessons for from Elijah, finishes this week, and that's a half-hour communion service. The following Wednesday is Ash Wednesday, so I just want to spotlight that, February 17th. You'll see a lot of PR about that in the coming days, but there will be multiple services, opportunities for all ages. We're going to be sending some ashes home to all the households of Good Shepherd. And if you're watching and won't necessarily have access to ashes, please know that you can certainly use oil for the anointing of the cross on your forehead on that day. We have some Lenten devotionals that we're going to have available outside the church. We have a safe box that you can just come by at your convenience. We'll have them available beginning today, and it'll be there until we run out. If by any chance the box if there's none in there, just let us know, and we'll restock as quick as we can. And finally, we have a new connection event on Sunday, the 28th, 3 weeks from today. If you're interested in joining the church or just simply want to learn more about the ministry here, send Mary Jo a note, and we'll get you connected to that. That'll occur via Zoom 3 weeks from today. Margot's going to read for us.
The reading is from 1 Corinthians, chapter 9. If I proclaim the gospel, this gives me no grounds for boasting, for an obligation is laid on me, and woe to me if I do not proclaim the gospel. For if I do this of my own will, I have a reward. But if not of my own will, I am entrusted with a commission. What then is my reward? Just this, that in my proclamation I may make the gospel free of charge, so as not to make full use of my rights in the gospel. For though I am free with respect to all, I have made myself a slave to all, so that I might win more of them. To the Jews I became as a Jew, in order to win Jews. To those under the law I became as one under the law, though I myself am not under the law, so that I might win those under the law. To those outside the law I became as one outside the law, though I am not free from God's law, but am under Christ's law, so that I might win those outside the law. To the weak I became weak, so that I might win the weak. I have become all things to all people, that I might by all means save some. I do it all for the sake of the gospel, so that I might share in its blessings. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Good morning, everyone. It's so great to be here to share another lesson with you. Adults are trying to sign up to get a shot that keeps you from getting a bad case of the COVID-19 sickness. But it's really tough to sign up to get that shot. Fortunately, my parents were finally able to get their shot about a week ago. But they had to sign up to go to a place that was pretty far from their house, and it snowed the day that they were supposed to go there. So my brother-in-law, Mike, drove over an hour in the snow to their house and picked them up, and drove another hour to their appointment to be sure that they got their shot. Now, I thanked Mike, but I wasn't surprised, because all of us we'll do whatever we can to help our family and friends be well, because we love them. Many very special people are healers, dedicating their lives to helping all people be well. As you will soon hear in the gospel, our Jesus story for today, Jesus himself is a healer. But before we talk about the gospel, I would like to tell you about a great Christian who was also one of the most famous healers in history. Her name is Florence Nightingale. Florence was born in the city of Florence, Italy, in 1820, That's 200 years ago, quite a while. She was super smart and loved to learn. She studied everything all the time. Italian, Latin, Greek, philosophy, history. Math was her favorite, writing, and eventually nursing, which is taking care of sick people. At the age of 17, she wrote these words in her diary. God called me in the morning and asked me, would I do good for him? Because of this message from God, Florence decided to go to a Lutheran school of nursing in Germany. Florence began nursing in London after she was finished school and quickly became a leader in hospital care. In 1843, she became the first woman ever to run a field hospital. Because she read so much, she learned about this brand new idea out there that there were these things called germs that were making people sick, and that these germs could be washed away. So she organized her hospital to be much, much cleaner and started this crazy new idea of washing your hands lots of times, something we still do 200 years later. Do you see that nickname on the slide? Lady with the lamp? Florence became known as the Lady with the Lamp because she would keep visiting her patients well into the night to be sure they were okay. Before Florence took over her hospital, only a bit more than half of the people in there were getting well enough to go home. After Florence took over, almost all the patients, 98% of her patients, got better and could go home. So everyone, doctors, presidents, even kings and queens, wanted Florence to teach them how to run hospitals. And Florence's detailed reports and rules created the modern nursing practices that we still do today. Florence believed that nursing honored a loving and generous God. She said that her life showed, and these are her words, how a woman of very ordinary ability has been led by God in strange and unaccustomed paths to do his service. God has done all, and I nothing. I've worked hard, very hard. That is all. And I've never refused God anything. Great words. In today's gospel story, which we will be reading in just a moment, Jesus goes to his friend's house, to Peter's house, where Jesus heals Peter's mother-in-law, who was sick with fever. That evening, everyone in the area brought their sick family and friends to Jesus to be healed. Because as you remember, all of us will do whatever we can to help our family and friends be well, because we love them. And Jesus healed them because Jesus loves them too. So it shouldn't surprise you that, like Florence, you can honor God by doing whatever you can to take care of your own health and the health of others. That includes washing your hands, eating well, sleeping well, wearing those masks, and praying for God to use his healing power for everyone who is sick. Let us pray. Dear God, thank you for all of the healers, including Jesus and Florence Nightingale. Help us be healers too, with clean and healthy things that we do. And please help all the people who are sick. Amen.
My Jesus, my Savior, Lord, there is none like you. all of my days, I want to praise the wonders of your mighty love. My comfort, my shelter, tower of refuge and strength, let every breath, all that I am, never cease to worship you. Shout to the Lord of the earth, let us sing. Power and majesty, praise to the King. Mountains bow down and the seas will roar at the sound of your name. I sing for joy at the work of your hands. Forever I'll love you, forever I'll stand. Nothing compares to the promise I have in you.
Such a beautiful song. Let's sing it again.
My Jesus, my Savior, Lord, there is none like you. All of my days, I want to praise the wonders of your mighty love. My comfort, shelter, tower of refuge and strength, let every breath, all that I am, never cease to worship you. Oh, shout to the Lord of the earth, let us sing. Power and majesty, praise to the King. Mountains bow down and the seas will roar at the sound of your name. I sing for joy at the work of your hands. Forever I'll love you, forever I'll stand. Nothing
The Holy Gospel according to St. Mark, the first chapter. As soon as they left the synagogue, they entered the house of Simon and Andrew with James and John. Now Simon's mother-in-law was in bed with a fever, and they told him about her at once. He came and took her by the hand and lifted her up. Then the fever left her, and she began to serve them. That evening at sundown, they brought to him all who were sick or possessed with demons, and the whole city was gathered around the door. And he cured many who were sick with various diseases and cast out many demons. And he would not permit the demons to speak because they knew him. In the morning, while it was still very dark, he got up and went out to a deserted place, and there he prayed. And Simon and his companions hunted for him. When they found him, they said to him, "Everyone is searching for you." He answered, "Let us go on to the neighboring towns, so that I may proclaim the message there also, for that is what I came to do." And he went throughout Galilee, proclaiming the message in their synagogues and casting out demons. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ.
Grace and peace be unto you from our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. You know, somewhere between 25, 28 years ago, when my wife was practicing law, her father called her one day and asked her if she could represent a family in the church. And thanks be to God, her law firm said she could do it, and she, in fact, could do it pro bono. You see, Peggy had been a faithful member of the church all of her life, and she had taught the three-year-old Sunday school class for years and years and years. But what had happened was her husband Frank had a massive, massive stroke in his late 40s, and he could no longer speak, couldn't communicate, and really couldn't do anything at all on his own. It was just what you would call devastating, painfully sad. Peggy needed someone who could accompany her and help her go through the court proceedings in Pennsylvania court so that she could get power of attorney so she could take control of all of his affairs. And all the while, she was saying, I really don't want to do this, but she knew she had to do it. She needed help. You know, she kept telling everyone, I could take care of him, I can communicate with him. She seemed to say, I understand what he needs, what he wants. And people just kept telling her, you're way in over your head. They thought the best thing for her would be if she could put him in a nursing home where he would have round-the-clock care. But Peggy kept saying, no way, no way, I'm going to take care of him myself. And so in a nutshell, by Pennsylvania law, Frank had to literally be in the courtroom to prove he was unable to communicate his wishes. So Francis has a doctor on the stand, and she's questioning him. And the doctor simply said, conveyed, without a doubt, this man will never speak, will never, ever be able to communicate again. And Francis said it was just gut-wrenching to look over at Frank and see the tears welling up in his eyes. But with that, Peggy took Frank home. She began valiantly trying to care for Frank full time. And it's interesting to note that one of her first reactions was to reach out to her church and ask for a Stephen minister to pray with her and offer her week in, week out support. And it's one of those ones we've had a Good Shepherd near here for nearly 20 years, and we've seen the blessing of having Christian caregivers come alongside people who need support and care. We'd be a different church if we didn't have that important ministry here. But the situation with Peggy and Frank seems so tragic. But you need to hear a little bit more about this couple. Frank used to hang out at the same bar with the same group of friends quite often. So Peggy reached out to them and said, I need your help. I need your help. So with that, the guys took it upon themselves to literally build a ramp into that bar so Frank could come and be with them. He would be wheeled in and they would just sit with him and he would be part of their connection group. Peggy was a bookkeeper, and thanks be to God, her company allowed her to move right away into telecommuting. So whenever Frank was asleep, that's when she would get her work done. She would place their grandchildren in his arms so he would be able to be close to them, a reminder of how much he was loved. Peggy, though, made one request of Frank. She said, you're going to go to church with me every week. So for the first time in his life, Frank became a weekly churchgoer. He'd be wheeled into the corner of the sanctuary. He'd get communion along with everyone else, but he was there week in and week out. Francis and I moved out of that community, but we continued to receive the newsletter. And this goes back more than probably 25 years ago. I remember her opening up a newsletter, and it was listing the new Sunday school teachers for the year. She read through the list, and it got down to the 3 and 4 year old class, and it said Peggy and Frank and some other person, but Frances called her dad and said, "For real, Frank's teaching. How's that possible?" And his response was so joyful and so enthusiastic. He said, well, things have changed for Frank. He's still in a wheelchair, but amazingly, he can communicate now. He has a limited use of his hand, but he can communicate with this machine. So he just loves teaching these kids. And he said the kids are absolutely wonderful. They absolutely adore him. They talk to him. They'll come over and climb on his lap and hug him, and he'll talk to them the best he can. But he said, no doubt, this is a powerful connection between him and these kids. The amazing thing to me when I recall that story is it's a story about the power of healing. Not necessarily, you know, certainly his health has improved some from when he first had the stroke, but it's not what you would call a full and complete physical healing. He's not the man he was prior to the stroke, but he has experienced the healing of God. The healing of God is about us becoming more and more whole, more and more the people God is calling us to be. And we become more the people God is calling us to be when we discover that our life is about serving others and being a faithful witness to Jesus. In the text today, Simon's mother-in-law was lying in bed with a fever. And if you just play around with that image a little bit, one of the things you can see or say is, well, she's sidelined right now. She's by herself, and she's not able to engage the world around her. But other people have recognized her state, her sidelined state. Peter, Andrew, James, and John, they go quickly to Jesus and let him know, hey, here is someone we love who's sidelined because of her health. And Jesus goes immediately to her, engages her, talks to her, holds her hand, and then lifts her up. And it says the fever left her. And immediately, what does she do? It says she gets up and she begins to serve. You know, I think some people will read that story and say, well, yes, it was a great day and a great Sabbath day where, she got up and was joyous and filled with energy again. It was a wonderful response. She cooked a meal, served others. That's pretty cool. But the text says a little bit more than that. The original translation really says the fever left her, and as a result, she from that point on was continually serving. In a sense, her life from that point on was all about this servant lifestyle. It's interesting to note that James and John, two of the disciples, were there that day. They saw this whole event. And down the road, they're going to get into an argument about, they asked Jesus, who's the greatest in the kingdom of God? And you remember what Jesus said. Jesus says, whoever wants to be first must be the servant of all. You know, Jesus never talked about volunteering. Nowhere does it say, well, be a part of my Jesus movement 1 hour a week or 2 hours a week. Jesus talked about being a servant of his day in and day out, 365 days a year, your whole life long. Giving yourself away daily to the community, to the people around you, to strangers, to loved ones. When someone embraces that call to be a servant, they're constantly on the lookout for ways to serve inside the church as well as outside the church. They just are hungering to bless colleagues, coworkers, friends, neighbors, people they don't even know. A servant is always looking to reaffirm commitments, but they're always looking for new challenges, new ways in which to interact with the world. Servants wake up and say, how can I bless someone today? How can I make other people's lives better? You know, volunteers do wonderful things in this world. They serve in spurts, but a volunteer can walk away. They can walk away. Servants are always on call, always ready to jump into the action. You know, you can't help but remember that the final night of Jesus' life, Jesus got up from the dinner table and washed the feet of his closest followers. It was what we would call a humble act, a profound act, an act of extreme servanthood. And Jesus said, do as I do. Imitate me. If you want to show the world love, this is what you do. Our call is to follow Jesus every day of our life, 365 days a year. And so in conclusion, I guess what I would say to all of you, the motto of our church is go serve. So to the people of Good Shepherd, to all who are worshiping with us this day, remind yourself to give of yourself every single day. Serve the Lord, serve each other in the church and outside the church, and make sure that you go out of your way to serve the world that needs a whole lot of love. Amen.
Brothers and sisters in Christ, let us stand together and pray the prayer of St. Francis. Lord, make us instruments of your peace. Where there is hatred, let us sow love. Where there is injury, pardon. Where there is discord, union. Where there is doubt, faith. Where there is despair, hope. Where there is darkness, light. Where there is sadness, joy. Grant that we may not so much seek to be consoled as to console, to be understood as to understand, to be loved as to love. For it is in giving that we receive, it is in pardoning that we are pardoned, and it is in dying that we are born to eternal life. Amen. Friends, God calls us to share together our time, our talents, and our treasures for the sake of God's ministry. Let us pray for the gifts that will be received. Great saving God, you have gathered us into one baptism, regardless of our backgrounds and conditions. Therefore, we praise you with our tithes and offerings. May they join with others to become a mighty river, bringing your peace and healing to the world. Amen.
In celebration of Black History Month, this month of February, Peter and I wanted to find some music that spotlighted some of the wonderful Black contemporary Christian artists that are out there. And we came across this song called Look No Further by this up-and-coming singer named Ebby McKinney. And wow, she just has a beautiful, beautiful voice. So I'm going to, with my humble efforts, try to do this song. Hope you enjoy it.
For the ones who feel like they're defeated, too weak to stand back up and fight. For the ones to running, he is waiting, like a father with arms open wide. Won't you lift your eyes from the ground? Heaven is calling out, come and see where true love is found. If you're looking for freedom, looking for a breakthrough, looking for somebody who knows every pain that you hold and the things that you're going through. If you got a heart that's broken into pieces, if you need a healer, a savior, a miracle maker, then you don't have to look no farther than Jesus. Look no farther than Jesus. For the ones who feel they've been rejected, for the ones who hang their heads in shame, won't you lift your eyes from your doubt? The cross is calling out with power that can turn your life around. If you're looking for freedom, looking for a breakthrough, looking for somebody who knows every pain that you hold and the things that you're going through. If you got a heart that's broken into pieces, if you need a healer, a savior, a miracle maker, then you don't have to look no farther than Jesus. Look no farther than Jesus. Oh, He's the place you will find your rest. He's the love that has no end. See the nail scars in His hands. No one else can do what He can. He's the place you will find rest. He's the love that has no end. See the nail scars in His hands. No one else can do what He can. If you're looking for freedom, looking for a breakthrough, looking for somebody who knows every pain that you hold and the things that you're going through. If you've got a heart that's broken into pieces, if you need a healer, a savior, a miracle maker, then you don't have to look no farther than Jesus. Look no farther than Jesus. No one else can do what He can. Look no farther than Jesus. Yeah. Look no farther than Jesus. Jesus.
Trusting God's power to heal, let us offer our prayers for all who are in need. Oh God, You are a God of healing. We pray for the church's ministries of healing, for faith-based hospitals, hospice care programs, and military chaplains, for those serving in prisons, camps, and nursing care facilities. We pray for Tom Turner and Stephen ministers of every time and place. Bring Your healing presence to ministries of healing in every program. Lord, in Your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
We pray for the health of the earth, for its many animals and their habitats, for all created life, that we may continue to strive to protect precious and fragile areas. Lord, in Your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
We pray for the health of people around the globe, for international health organizations and Lutheran World Relief, for the Red Cross and all others who seek to bring aid and relief for those affected by the global pandemic. Lord, in Your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
We pray for wholeness in our nation, for FEMA, for the National Health Service and National Guard and their work, for the safety of our nation's elected leaders. Bring an end to domestic violence, prejudice, and civic terrorism of any kind. Lord, in Your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
We pray for a halt to this pandemic, for all who have contracted COVID-19 and still experience symptoms, for health workers, for the prompt distribution of vaccines, and for all who have had loved ones to die of this virus. Be with those who are seeking to help. Lord, in Your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for all who are sick and suffering, for those with chronic pain, for those experiencing despair, and for all whom we name now, the Booker family, Joel and Doris Berg, June Bingaman, Bruce Brown, Mike Camarado, Book Cotter, Elsie DeWall, Franz Foltz, Walter and Russell Kleinman and their parents, Polly Matkovich, Margaret Miller, Ann Pratt Proctor, Tamara Price, Brian Troutman, Mort, and all whom we name now. Stand beside them in time of trial. Lord, in Your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for those who are hungry, for those on this Super Bowl Sunday who don't have a bowl of soup to eat. Bring Your blessing for Gaithersburg help and for the families who will receive the diapers that we have collected this week. Like loaves and fishes, multiply our efforts and provide for their every need. Lord, in Your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for ourselves and for this congregation. Give us steady trust in Your power and health in our weaknesses. Bless the partners of this ministry, especially Michael and Debbie Hirschberger, Brandon and Jamie and Tenley Higgs, Artis Hill, Mike and Ruth Hill, and Alex Hodak. We thank you for all who support and bless our shared ministry together. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We praise you for the faithfully departed and for their lives of service to others. We give you thanks for Florence Nightingale and for her witness to your call, and for Mary Nuss and the praise that she brought through her music, for Pastor Dave Brighton and his service through his ministry. We pray that despite sickness and death, at our end, we will join with them to find our wholeness in you. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Merciful God, hear the prayers of your people, spoken or silent, for the sake of the one who dwells among us, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray.
Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Go out into the world in peace. Have good courage. Hold on to what is good. Return no one evil for evil. Strengthen the faint-hearted. Uphold the weak. And help the suffering. Honor all people. Love and serve the Lord, rejoicing in the power of the Holy Spirit.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. Amen.
Amen.
Here we go, everybody.
I'm so glad Jesus lifted me. I'm so glad Jesus lifted me. I'm so glad Jesus lifted me. Singing glory, hallelujah. Jesus lifted me. Satan had me bound, but Jesus lifted me. Satan had me bound. Well, Jesus lifted me. Satan had me bound, but Jesus lifted me. Singing glory, hallelujah. Jesus lifted me. When I was in trouble, Jesus lifted me. When I was in trouble, Jesus lifted me. When I was in trouble, Jesus lifted me. Singing glory, hallelujah. Jesus lifted me.
Come on, Vicky.
Ra-ba-ba-da-da-da. Oh, Jesus lifted me. Ba-ba-ba-da-ba. Oh, Jesus lifted me. Singing glory, hallelujah. Jesus lifted me.
Everybody now.
I'm so glad Jesus lifted me. I'm so glad, well, Jesus lifted me. I'm so glad Jesus lifted me. Singing glory, hallelujah, Jesus lifted me.
Now go in peace. Christ is with you. Thanks be to God.
My Jesus, my Savior,
Lord, there is none like you.
All of my days I want to praise the wonders of your mighty love. My comfort, my shelter, tower of refuge and strength. Let every breath, all that I am,
the Lord, all the earth let us sing. Power and majesty, praise to the King. Mountains bow down and the seas will roar at the sound of your name. I sing for joy at the work of your hand.